everybody. We shall wait for more viewers to view the video, and then we can start about hair care. Okay, usually I'll do my skincare and makeup only, right? So this time I'm going to do hair care. Okay, what do you do for hair loss or itchy scalp, and then for dry hair and all those hair problem lah? I did not plan this video at all, so this is just super random video that I'm going to do for you guys. So sorry if I blabber a bit, and just wait for a few more of you to come online. Okay, and then we shall start. Hello, hello, hi, how are you? Hi Raja, how are you? Had your lunch? Okay, let me just start with the hair care. Okay, so I'm not a hair expert at all, but I'm just going to share with you guys what I usually use for my hair. Okay, because I had super damaged hair because I used to rebond my hair every single year. Yes, for almost about donkey years, more than 15 years. I always, every year, I always rebond my hair. So it was really, really damaged, and now I've stopped rebonding my hair. So instead, I'm trying to maintain my hair as much as I can with the products that's at home. Okay, I try not to go for any kind of treatments outside. Instead, I'm trying my own home remedies, hair remedies. So I just want to share with you the home remedies where you also can try. It might work for some, it might not. So do let me know if you have tried it. Okay, so firstly, but yes, as for rebonding, right, I did rebonding just at the top. Only the top part, because my hair is super super frizzy. It's not easy to manage at all, so it's really frustrating. So because of that, I just rebonded just the top area only, so it's easy to manage. You know, you can just throw your hair any way you like. But then the bottom part, I did not do anything, so it's super natural. I did not rebond for almost 2 years plus. Yeah, so I have a pretty wavy wavy curly kind of hair, so I'm just maintaining this. Okay, I really hope that, you know, I can outgrow my hair nice and smooth and shiny. So to maintain your hair, what do you need on weekly basis? Okay, so I'm going to show you three ingredients, actually not three ingredients, two ingredients and one cap that I use every night. Okay, so the first one is apple cider vinegar. All right, this apple cider vinegar, this is my go-to product. I love this so much. I even drink this. Okay, if y'all can see. Okay, you can see all this stuff inside lah. Yeah, so I even used to drink this every morning. I'll mix with like 1 cup of water, like 1 teaspoon of the apple cider vinegar, and then with 1 cup of water. Well, okay, for hair, yes, I use this. So the first step I do is to rinse my hair with shampoo. The shampoo that I'm using currently is this one. Okay, so this one is 0% silicone, and then the conditioner I'm using is keratin smooth. Yeah, okay, so these are the two products I'm using for my hair. I usually will change my shampoo brand. I don't stick to one brand. I like to change according to the needs. Sometimes my hair is my scalp is a little itchy, you know, I'll use a different kind of shampoo. So yeah, try not to stick to one brand. Okay, try to change your shampoo every month or so. Okay, so currently I'm using this shampoo. So the first step is I will wet my hair, and then I will wash my hair with this shampoo, after which I will pour this apple cider vinegar on my scalp and massage it. So what I'll do is I always pour in this kind of bottle. Okay, so this apple cider vinegar, maybe this much I will pour inside, and then this much will be water. Okay, you have to dilute your apple cider vinegar. Actually, sometimes I don't dilute the apple cider vinegar. I'll just pour right onto my scalp and start massaging it. It's good if you can leave it for about 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, it really helps to balance your pH. It helps with itchy scalp. It helps to smoothen your hair, get a more shiny texture. Okay, and it also helps with dandruff. If those who have dandruff, you should definitely try this apple cider vinegar. It works wonders. And also for hair growth and hair loss. Okay, I used to have very bad hair loss, all right? And everywhere I walk around, you can see hair all over. So whenever I have that kind of hair loss, I always use this apple cider vinegar. Okay, I'll massage onto my scalp. I'll leave it for a minute or two. Usually 5 to 10 minutes is good, but I'm a lazy bum, so I don't really leave it for 5 or 10 minutes. Instead, I'll just leave it for a minute or two, and then I'll rinse it off. Some of them don't like to rinse off. Okay, there's a few different ways that you can use this apple cider vinegar. After washing your hair, you just have to rinse your hair with the apple cider vinegar, which is diluted, and then you can just dry your hair. Okay, you don't blow dry, but you just, you know, let it dry naturally. But for me, I would like to rinse a bit with water. It's because the smell is really, really strong. So not all of us will like that kind of strong smell on our hair, right? So I always rinse it off, and then I will use the conditioner at the bottom of my hair, on the roots, just till here. Don't put conditioner on your scalp. It's going to damage your scalp. So just until here, okay? You use the conditioner, and then you rinse off your hair. Okay, so this is the step that I do at least once a week, or like 2 weeks once. Okay, and then another thing I'd like to do is coconut oil. I think that's one of our favorite product. Okay, this is a natural extra virgin coconut oil. So what I'll do is I will take like 2 or 3 tablespoons of coconut oil. I will massage onto my scalp and my hair. I really massage it well. And then I'll leave it on for about 1 hour to 2 hours. Okay, 1 to 2 hours. So it's up to you. You can also leave it for maybe 30 minutes. It's good enough. Or 1 to 2 hours is also good. Okay, coconut oil really helps to give that shine to your hair and that softness. My hair is very rough. Used to be very, very rough. But now you can see that, you know, there's a lot of good shine. It looks more healthy compared to last time. Okay, last time looks like maybe broom or brush. Yeah, so now it's way much more soft and smooth. And it also helps to moisturize your hair. So my hair used to be very dry. So after using this coconut oil, it really, really made my hair, gave that moisture to my hair. Okay, so it's not very dry right now. All right, and also helps with split ends. I really had very bad split ends. So that's the reason why I cut my hair short. Actually, I had even longer hair. My length was even longer. But I now started using the coconut oil every week. So every Sunday, I'll massage into my hair, and then I will rinse it off. As in, I'll wash off with my shampoo and my conditioner. Okay, you cannot use apple cider vinegar and coconut oil together. It's a nope. Okay, use maybe 1 week, use coconut oil. Another week, use apple cider vinegar. Or in a week, use coconut oil once and then apple cider vinegar another time. Maybe after about 4 to 5 days later. Okay, I don't mix both together. Okay, and those who use coconut oil, after soaking your hair with coconut oil, if you don't want to use conditioner, it's perfectly fine because this works as a conditioner as well. Okay, so yeah, this is a very simple step that you can do at home if you have hair loss, especially hair loss, because I have so many friends asking me, what do you do for hair loss? You know, what do you do? What shampoo do you use? Or what treatment do you do? So I don't go for any treatment for it. I just use my apple cider vinegar, and that's the only magic that works on my hair for now. And thanks to my friend for introducing me, my bestie Janice. She's the one who introduced this apple cider vinegar donkey years back. And then I started researching, and then I started learning more about it, and it worked great. It works super, super great. Even today, I washed my hair with apple cider vinegar. Yeah, because I think 4 to 5 days ago, I used coconut oil, and then my hair started to be quite greasy because I do quite a number of work. So I don't know, it just became quite greasy. So I just wanted to have a more shiny and soft hair. So I used apple cider vinegar today. So all I did was quickly rinse my hair with shampoo, and then I pour this solution, as in apple cider vinegar and water, I diluted, right? I pour this onto my scalp, I massaged, I leave it for a minute, I rinsed it off, and then I use my conditioner just at the end of my hair. And then I washed again. So, and then I use my hair dryer to blow dry my hair. Usually when I want to go out, I usually blow dry my hair. And then I put some oil just at the top here. Okay, you can use any kind of olive oil or coconut oil or anything just to smoothen out your little frizzy hair at the top, this area. I don't like to put it on my scalp because it will give that greasy look, so I don't like it. So I just put just at the end. Okay, this one guys and girls all can do, can use these products. Okay, hi, hello. Yeah, okay, if you all have any questions, just drop into the comment box below about hair. As I said, I'm not a hair specialist, but these are the few products that I use which works wonders. And one more thing, satin cap. Okay, this is a satin cap. So we all know that sleeping on a cotton pillow, right? Like our pillow cover is cotton. Usually we use a cotton cover. So it gives your hair, it makes your hair more frizzy when you wake up. Okay, because you know, like me, if y'all are like me, tossing and turning around like nobody's business, so that will give that frizziness to your hair. Okay, so instead, I like to use this one. I just started using this actually. This is a satin cap. Okay, this is a satin cap. So I just put on my head. Okay, I'll roll my hair. I don't use any clip. I'll just roll my hair. Okay, like that. And then I'll just put it on. Okay, I'll look like a chef if I do it now. So yeah, I'll put it on and then I will sleep. Okay, so next day you don't feel your hair very frizzy. It will be soft, silky and smooth. So this is another trick that you guys can try. I bought it from Lazada. I don't know how much I bought it from for. I think about a few dollars only lah. Okay, just I think less than $5. Yeah, I bought it from Lazada, so you can try. I don't know where else they sell this, so just get it from Lazada. As for apple cider vinegar, you can buy it from NTUC, from Unity, Guardian, wherever they're selling. This coconut oil, I bought it from iHerb. Okay, I bought it from iHerb. You can also buy coconut oil from NTUC. They're also selling all the extra virgin coconut oil. Okay, and you can buy any kind of bottle you want, spray bottle. My spray bottle spoiled already, so I'm using this mini one. So you can see all these things inside. I don't know whether y'all can see or not. See, things are floating inside. Yeah, this is from the apple cider vinegar. Okay, so I diluted it. Yeah. And then, yeah, I think that's about it. If y'all have any questions, don't hesitate to leave your questions in the comment box below. And then I'll be coming up with a makeup or a skincare video really soon. So I'll see you guys soon, okay? Take care. Love you all. Bye.